So in today's video, I'm actually gonna be showing you my everyday carry, and I have pretty much everything right in front of me. And this is gonna be in no particular order. This is pretty much my everyday carry regarding technology and things like that. So you're gonna see a lot of tech items in this actual video specifically. And I'm not actually gonna show you the bag that I actually use when it comes to my everyday carry or when it comes to me traveling and things like that, because, well, it's pretty generic and there's nothing too crazy about the bag. And I don't want the main focus or one of the focuses in this video to actually be the bag itself. You decide what type of bag you wanna carry when it comes to your items. But let's start off with everything that I normally bring when I go on a trip or when I have to go places regarding technology and things like that. First off, I guess let's start with one of the main pieces to my kit, of course, and one of the main pieces to my kit is gonna be my smartphone of choice. So what smartphone am I actually rocking on a daily basis? Well, the smartphone that I'm actually rocking on a day-to-day basis is actually gonna be the Samsung Galaxy S10, and this one specifically, the S10 Plus. I'm rocking the Spec Candy Shell, I think, or something like this. This is a pretty generic one. They sell at normal retailers like Best Buy, Walmart, and Target. Overall, I like my experience with the case. I like my experience with the Samsung Galaxy S10. Overall, this is a certified badass phone, and you can get this on sale quite often. So if you're looking for a pretty solid smartphone and you want the latest and greatest from Samsung, it is gonna be the Samsung Galaxy S10 line. I do know the Note 10 is literally months away at this moment, or maybe it's coming out next month, but this phone is still a solid phone, and this phone is still a phone to get even when the Note 10 comes out, because when the Note 10 comes out, this phone is probably gonna get a heavy discount compared to their premium flagship, which is probably gonna be the Note 10, so you're gonna get some good discounts on the S10 line. But yes, I love everything about my experience with this phone. The S10 Plus specifically is a pretty badass phone. And then the next thing on my list will be a battery bank, and here is my battery bank of choice. Nothing too crazy about this battery bank. I do have the one from Anker, and this one is I think a 20,000 milliamp, so it's one of those very hefty battery banks when it comes to Anker battery packs. The nice thing about this, it does support fast charging. The one downside I'm kind of disappointed with this charger specifically is the fact that this charger from Anker only has one USB port on the actual device and not multiple USB ports to charge multiple devices. It does have a USB Type-C port. It does show you your battery life. Overall, this is a very good battery bank, and if you need some of the most use you can possibly get at a pretty reasonable price, in my opinion, I would definitely go with the 20,000 milliamp Anker battery. I like pretty much everything about this device. It is a certified device, and you can never go wrong with battery banks. So if you definitely need a battery backup, I would definitely highly get one for those long road trips or for those long vacations, or just if you're traveling a lot. Battery banks are necessary, and they're very worth every penny of your purchase. The next thing on my list is I just have a little microfiber. So if, for instance, I have to clean my smartphone or do some cleaning on my glasses or something like that, I will have a microfiber. So here's a microfiber cleaning bag or whatever it is, but here it is right here. And then the next thing on my list when it comes to work and things like that, I do carry around this little a USB card reader. It does use the old mini USB, not micro USB, so it's pretty much very old at this point, but for what this is, it does work very well. The only thing about this, which I will admit does suck about this one specifically, is the fact that it is only USB 2.0. So if you're working with 4K files, this thing is gonna be ridiculously slow, and I honestly would not recommend this at all if you're thinking about using 4K files and you need to transfer stuff very fast. But if you're working with small to medium, like 1080p files, this will still serve the purpose and do very well. I just wish this was USB 3.0. I guess I just didn't have a reason to upgrade with what type of files I specifically work with. But it pretty much is an all-in-one card reader. You can see it pretty much has every card known to man, which you guys know at this point. The most common types of cards are micro SD and micro SD and standard SD. The rest of the formats aren't too widely used anymore. I like the fact that this thing is very lightweight. It's matte finish. The the mini USB is removable on this device, so it, if it ever did snap, I can just throw it out and buy a brand new one. It's not soldered on this thing overall. This weighs, it's really light. You can see it's flipping in my hands, but definitely a certified device right there. And of course, I pretty much always need one of these on a regular basis to do things on the internet. But there it is right there, my all-in-one USB card reader. The next thing on my list is going to be my cameras. What kind of cameras do I actually bring around with me on a regular basis? Well, the camera that I normally bring around with me on a regular basis is just this GoPro Hero. I do have a GoPro Hero. It's not the latest and greatest GoPro Hero. It's actually the GoPro Hero 2018, which I did modify to be a GoPro Hero 2015 model. And overall, this is a very nice camera. The reason I mainly shoot this when I'm out and about is just due to the fact that this thing is very small. It's waterproof. It's rugged. It even has a lens cap on the actual lens to protect it if you drop this thing. Overall, this thing is a very sturdy camera, and I don't actually bring the camera that I'm actually shooting this footage on around with me just because it's too expensive for what it is. So I keep it pretty much as a studio camera only, but here is the camera I use on a regular basis. You probably don't see any footage of this actual camera because a lot of the things that I actually do with this camera specifically is gonna be for my Patreon supporters only. I do behind the scenes stuff. I'm doing some vlog stuff and things like that. But if you want to check out my Patreon, I will try to have a link down in the description below where you can subscribe to me for $5 a month, and you can see all the behind the scene footage. You can see me in different spots and things like that when it comes to my Patreon campaign. But anyway, I do like using the GoPro, and GoPro is a pretty useful device, just specifically since it's such a small camera. It can fit in places where normal cameras don't normally fit in. But the main reason I bring this around with me in my bag is because it's so easy to just point and shoot at something and you're good to go. It has a wide angle lens, and overall it just makes sense, and I just don't want to worry about a big camera. What if it damages? What scenario? So I do have the GoPro Hero 2018. The next thing on my list is going to be my entertainment. What type of entertainment do I actually bring around with me? But before I talk about that, actually, I want to talk about my laptop of choice, since I do carry around a laptop with me. Now, the laptop I actually have, funny enough, is not even my laptop. It's actually a rental, and I'm renting it out. The laptop I have, which I actually talked about on my YouTube channel about a month ago, I talked about a MacBook, because I am currently using a MacBook for my everyday work when it comes to YouTube and things like that. And so far, my experience with this MacBook, I think 15-inch 2017, 2018 model, I forgot what model it is again, but I did a video about this. If you scroll down on my YouTube channel, you'll see something like I switched to Mac OS, and then in that video, I tell you what Mac I'm using, but I currently don't have the Mac on me to show you the Mac, but take my word, I am using a MacBook Pro 2017 model, I do believe. So that's something, and overall I've liked every experience with it, and it's one of the higher end models too. It's an i7, 16 gig of RAM, 256 SSD and everything like that, and so far I've loved everything about it. So that's what I'm normally using if I'm out and about and I need a laptop for work or just do things on the laptop. That's my laptop of choice. And then the next thing, of course, let's get back into the entertainment. Let's talk about some entertainment options. First off, I do want to show you my USB cable, because this is the USB cable I normally bring around with me. It's a USB Type-C cable, since so many items on this table are USB Type-C. I bring this around on my everyday carry. And the nice thing about this USB cable is the fact that it's one of those rope styles, and this does have a lifetime warranty. And this cable is actually made by Anker, if you can see right there. And I do like this cable one heck of a lot, just because you can bend it, you can pretty much twist it as hard as you can, and it's made out of some kind of nylon rope material. And I've had this cable specifically for about a year now, and this cable has not busted on me, not broke on me. The reason I actually wanted something like this is because I do have other cables, and usually what happens with other cables, they usually end up breaking on me
in like 6 months to a year. It's not because I don't take care of my cables. It just happens to be that cables are very fragile for whatever the reason, and I always have bad luck with cables. So I wanted something as sturdy as possible, and this one fits the bill and it's still going and it's very sturdy, and it's a very nice cable from Anker. So if you're looking for some cables for your device, whether it's an iPhone, whether it's a USB type C device, this bad boy right here will do the job. And then the next thing I have on the table, and talking about my entertainment, I still do bring around my Nintendo 3DS XL, or the new Nintendo 3DS XL. Let me go ahead and unzip this so I can show you exactly what I'm talking about. But here's the device right here. I do have the new 3DS XL right here. I have it in a case. This pretty much is in still mint condition because I take care of all my stuff, but here it is right here, and I have a lot of games for this, so I still bring this around from time to time to try to get some use out of this aging system. And I know they don't make any more games for this. They're pretty much done making games for the new 3DS, or the 3DS line in general, but overall I do carry it around, and I do like some of my games that I still have on this system, since I have probably over 20 to 30 games on this bad boy. And then the next thing I do have is gonna be, of course, my Nintendo Switch. Here is my Nintendo Switch. Nothing too crazy about my Nintendo Switch. It's just in this pouch right here. I have the standard gray one with the gray Joy-Cons, and this is the case that came out I think around the time the Switch actually launched, and you can hear this. It is a very sturdy case, so if you're looking for a very sturdy case that's specifically made for the Nintendo Switch, this one will fit the bill. And the nice thing about this case is the fact that this case in particular does have slots for things like game cartridges, headphones, some accessories and things like that, but it won't carry everything the Nintendo Switch has to offer, but it is still a good solid carrying case. The next thing on my list are gonna be my headphones of choice. Let's start off with my wired option. I still do bring wired headphones around with me. The main reason I bring wired headphones around with me like this is the fact that the Nintendo Switch and the 3DS don't actually have Bluetooth embedded, and since they don't have Bluetooth embedded, I still have to carry around wired headphones. It does kind of suck. Nintendo, specifically with the Nintendo Switch, won't actually give us Bluetooth embedded. I'm hoping with the next Nintendo Switch, like a Nintendo Switch Pro or something like that, they'll roll out some type of Bluetooth implementation. I know, of course, they do make Bluetooth adapters for the Nintendo Switch, but I've been just too lazy to go buy one, and honestly, wired headphones don't bother me, and they're also good just for a backup headphone if you need some audio. Maybe you're listening to something important, like a voice call on your phone, or maybe you're trying to make a phone call and you're in an area that's very noisy and things like that, and maybe your Bluetooth headphones like die on you or whatever. You do have a wired option, so I don't mind bringing around a wired option just for options and for a backup, of course. And then one of my favorite pairs of headphones, hands down, I just got these like a couple months ago, and these are some of my favorite headphones, is the Samsung Galaxy Buds. I've made a review on the Samsung Galaxy Buds already, but overall, I like my experience hands down with these. They're some of the most convenient headphones you'll ever use. Even if you don't buy these ones specifically, I highly recommend buying some type of true wireless earbuds. They're just so convenient. Nobody really notices that you're listening to music. You have them in your ears. They're very unintrusive. They don't get in the way. Overall, they're just badass headphones, and they actually do provide a pretty nice, solid, secure fit when you're talking about things like noise isolation and sound quality. They're very good. One thing I did not talk about when it comes to my review of this product specifically, I didn't actually go over the fact that I wanted to mention one thing with these headphones. The one thing I do have a problem with these headphones now, after using them for like 3 to 4 months now, I will have to admit the problem I'm running into sometimes. The audio in this is just a little bit too quiet, in my opinion, and you do have to turn up the volume pretty loud before you feel like it's even comfortable to listen to. So for instance, on like Samsung certified devices, you know, when you start cranking up the volume too high, it'll say like, warning, if you crank it up any higher, it may damage your hearing. But with these, I'm telling you, on some songs, it will depend on the song, I want to make that clear, but in a lot of songs, I have to go past that warning, this will damage your ears, because it's just too low, in my opinion, on some songs. Again, it will vary on songs, but overall, these are definitely worth every price of the $130 asking value of these, and these are what I carry around every day, and these are probably in my pocket almost 99% of the time. So if you ever do see me in real life, I'm probably be having these in my pocket because I use them so often. And then the next thing on my list is gonna be a true wireless, not true wireless, but noise canceling headphones. And here's my noise canceling headphones of choice. You probably see so many other people talk about this. I have the Sony 1000XM2, I think it's called. I know they make an XM3 at the moment, but I looked into buying those, and if I was to trade this off and even pay the extra, a little bit extra for the upgraded XM3s, I heard they're not that much better. So I'm probably gonna wait until Sony releases like an XM4 or something like that, because these ones are still very solid. They're very nice and things like that. I love my experience. I guess the only downside to this, there's two downsides to this pair of headphones. They're an amazing pair of noise canceling headphones. The sound is phenomenal out of these. Maybe not the best sound of any headphones ever, but they are good for what they are. Definitely $350. I can definitely justify that if you use them all the time and you need solid noise canceling in areas where it's just too noisy and things drive you nutty. These are definitely worth every penny and they're badass. Honestly, the only two downsides to this I can actually think of is, one, this only supports Bluetooth 4.1, I do believe. I could be wrong about that, but I'm pretty sure when this came out, for some reason, it was Bluetooth 4.1, so you don't get the benefits of Bluetooth 5.0. And then the other downside to this one, specifically the XM2s, was the fact that it just came out it didn't really come out at the wrong time. It's just that for some weird reason, Sony decided, let's make a premium noise canceling headphone, but let's not actually put USB Type-C on it. And USB Type-C was already on the market, and a lot of things used USB Type-C when these actually came out, because these came out, I think, in 2017, and we already had things like the Nintendo Switch. A lot of laptops were using USB Type-C, even a lot of headphones were starting to push for USB Type-C. So honestly, it just does not make sense to why these are USB Type-C. So the only reason why I would even consider the upgraded version of this, the XM3, would actually have to be for the USB Type-C connection. That would be my biggest thing, but I just don't think it's worth it to go out of my way to get something that's slightly more better than these, just to have the convenience of USB Type-C anyway. But yeah, I think that pretty much wraps up this video of everything that I carry on a regular basis when it comes to regarding to tech. Now you know pretty much what's in my bag all the time. I'm gonna show you a picture right now of pretty much everything laid out, so you can see everything that I just talked about if you're interested in any of these items. Anyway, guys, this is Wayne from MyTech News signing out.